Hey y'all, it's Spiritual Life Coach 43 here to do the life coaching session number 4. Guys, time is just moving. It is called Love Yourself. This is the topic. I knew it had something to do with love. I just do topics based on how they come to me. If you're new to my channel, you may not know that I'm a life coach and I'm also a spiritual advisor, so I do tarot readings as well. If you want a tarot reading or life coaching session, they are not the same. Tarot's with oracle cards or tarot cards and those types of messages for you in your life. And life coaching is just, it could be the same questions, but that would come from straight from advice, not tarot. So not the same. If you want that, whether you're new or my returning subscriber, if you're a watcher, which I appreciate everybody, please read the description box below. This is a life coaching session. So this is free knowledge, basically what I'm sharing, how I think, what I feel. I'm very connected to spirit and to God. So I relay messages based on my experience, based on my education, and just everything. And I put it all together. And I give you the best of me to the best of my ability. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment. Thank you all for being with me. Blessings and abundance to all my viewers, watchers, returning subscribers. Thank you so much to all my new subscribers. I'm seeing it pick up, and I am grateful for each and every one of you. Please know that any donations is always appreciated. And just know that I love you and I appreciate you so much. Today is May 15th, 2020. Goodness gracious, we're like basically in the middle of the month. June is rolling, summer is coming. Without further ado, let's start, you guys. Love yourself. Okay, this is something that everybody needs to practice. Something everybody should be doing. It's something that is not just learned from like watching how your family loves you. That's one way. The other way is really getting to a place where you understand that you're important and to know that. And that takes building that confidence, building that self-esteem, building yourself up is loving yourself, okay? So I got my cards here and then I'll explain as we go. Let's start with the first one. I forgot the number one, but oh well. Please know that God will bless you. You have to be getting that relationship with God. And that was my very first life coaching session. So if you want to go back and look at some of the old videos, please do. You have to know that God loves you and he will bless you and be close to spirit. You have to be in prayer. God will send you better and what you need. If you lost something that you really loved and it was great or something tragic happened to you, understand that we are all in the same boat. We just catch that wave at different times. Okay, that wave knocks us over too. But as long as we are still afloat, get up and keep going and keep surviving and keep living. And stay close to God, learn about God, know God, have that relationship right. And it's important to build that because you will love yourself more because you will understand that you are significant and every life has more than one purpose. We have purposes and we come here to fulfill that. And you have to stay close to God and know that things will get better and you will be blessed. Okay. Also, set some boundaries. Okay. I think a lot of us haven't learned to say no in a very polite way or haven't learned to let people know, hey, this is too much responsibility for me. All I can do is this. So we are so into pleasing people and giving our all to others. We forget that we need to make sure we have boundaries. If not, people will cross them. And the only person who will feel that is us. Okay. Only you know how you feel. So maybe, you know, if you're dating somebody, let them know, I need you to be consistent and check in with me once a week. Or, send me some phone calls or shorten your phone calls. If you're on the phone with your friends and you have a lot of friends and or you have friends and everybody wants your time, everybody wants your attention and you just can't do it. You're going to be exhausted having 3-hour conversations with each one of them. So some things you may have to shorten that to an hour each or 30 minutes each, especially if you're in college or you have a job and you have a child or you have a full life and a family. If you're just busy or you just need rest or you're sick and you're recovering, whatever you're going through, you have to make sure there's time for you. And weed people out, you know, setting these boundaries, you will weed people out because people who do not respect you, they won't respect your boundaries. And that's how you know that's not a real friend. That's not somebody you need in your life if they can't appreciate the time you do give to them. Okay. And know that you will you will not break. Is that what that says? I'm not even sure what my own writing is. I'm looking at my notes. Let me see if I can decipher what this means. Know that you will and will not break. Oh, okay. Bend. It's okay to bend. But okay, I know what I mean. It's okay to bend sometimes for some people, But certain boundaries you just can't break. Like when it comes to, if you're a person who don't tolerate cheating in a relationship, do not bend. Do not break. They do that, it's over. And yes, it will hurt like hell. Yes, you will be in pain. Yes, you will suffer and go through some things. But you have to do what's best for you. If you don't tolerate, nobody should tolerate beating, stealing, lying, disloyalty. Those are boundaries not to cross. Some things you just cannot cross. It's not okay. But you can bend certain things. Like say, for example, if you told somebody, you know, I need a little bit more time to myself, and you end up saying, okay, if I do give this person time, then I'm going to take extra time for myself tomorrow. You know, you know what you need. You know when you should bend. But I think when you set those boundaries, your main boundaries, do not bend those. Do not break those, okay? There's small ones that you may bend here and there. I said you couldn't have that ice cream cone to your daughter until after dinner. And you might say, you know what, I'm going to be the cool mom right now and just be like, yo, go ahead and have it. You already got it. You've cleaned up. You've earned it. This time I'll bend. But do not bend again. Okay, so certain little instances, you know when to bend, but don't break. But if you mean wait, that's what you mean. So mean what you say what you mean, and own it. Okay? And this goes right with setting those boundaries, is having standards. This is a major one. So many of us do have standards, but we don't communicate them. We have to make sure we're communicating these standards. And I know, especially in a romantic relationship or even friendship, sometimes we don't communicate them until we're fed up, until it's too late. I think we have to start opening up and communicating before then. Okay. The right people will respect them. Okay. They will rise up to the occasion, and they will look at you like, yeah, this girl has standards. This guy has standards. He is on the right track in life, and he values himself. Okay. Raise up and rise to the occasion of having those standards. You know, the good thing is the wrong people will run. The good people will stay. Okay. Let the people and the souls who are not getting it right, let them run, because they probably don't have standards or high enough ones for themselves. Which leads me to the next point. This is stand by your morals. So we all have morals. We all have values. We all have things that we were taught that we know right from wrong. And, you know, having those morals is having the right ethics, doing what's right, even when it's hard, even when it's very hard. So that comes with maturity and lessons learned. Okay. And you'll stand by your morals as you show what your desires are, and you tell people what they are, and you actually own it and you mean it. You will stand by your morals and your values and your desires, which leads me right to values. Okay? So some of the values I have is college, family, education, success, growth, church, God, building with others. Know your values. And I would say, and your morals and your standards and stuff, make a list of what these things really are. What do you value? What do you care about? What matters most to you? If drinking matters most to you, then that's not a good value to have. If elevating yourself in life is a good value to have, then yes, that is a good value to have. And it's one that everybody should have. You know, what's important to you? Make that list of what that means and what that looks like to you, because that will help you stay on track and remind you of what is significant in your life. And it will help you to remember to tell other people. You know, we show people about what we do, but we also need to tell people too. I think it goes hand in hand. That communication has to go hand in hand. I mean, we have traditions, and there's certain things that people do. Some people do Sunday dinner, which I think is great. You know, I don't, but some people do. But as you know, and the values can change, and you can add to them as well. But certain things I value, like I want somebody around me who's very educated. My friends are highly educated. Some of them have 3 and 4 degrees and going back to school. We're dealing with masters. Some people have like more than one, several or multiple masters. Degrees and bachelors, and I don't look down on anybody who don't have that, but that's a high value for me and the people around me, and I'm glad we just gel like that. They value family, they value God. You know, I want to hear a man say, I love God. That means a lot to me, to hear that, and not just a man, but women too. My friends, I know they do, and they say they do. I like friends who pray for me, who actually turn to God when there's difficult times and not just run away, but actually go to the Lord. That means a lot to me. So write down what your values, list them, and discuss them with your friends and your family and the people that's important. And think about that when you're dating. Think about that when you're raising your kids. And, you know, just a reminder for yourself, too. That will help you love yourself, because you'll stand by something that's strong and with a good foundation for yourself. My next one, I love this one a lot. Speak love, life, and light into yourself. I love that. Tell yourself that you're beautiful, that you're worth it, that you are enough. Before a job interview, give yourself a pep talk. I can do this. I've done this before. I'm going to nail this. I'm going to give it my all and be at my best. Encourage yourself during your highs and your lows and in betweens, okay? Remember to look for the positive things in life. You know, if somebody says something negative to you, oh, you're not that good at this. Well, I'm great at that. You know, flip that and I'm great at this, but I'm learning. You know, I may not be great at this yet, but I'm learning. I'm trying. And I will keep trying until I get it. Or I'm learning, but I'm so great at this, this, and this. So speak positivity, especially when people are negative. Okay? And don't feel like you can't do something you don't know until you've tried, and you don't know until you continue to try. So keep going. The next one is to recognize low vibrational people. Recognize these people, and they will stand out because they will say small, meaningless things. They don't have in-depth conversations ever or very rare. They are on a low vibration. They always think negative. They worry too much. Cut who you don't need out your life. Okay, keep your circle small is what I recommend. It's okay to network, but no, those are my networks. Okay, friends and pals and networks are not the same. Associates are not the same. Put people in a category that they belong into so that everybody's not like, oh, that's a friend. Everybody's not a friend. So look for people who have ambition and growth. They have goals and they're goal-minded and they reflect. I love a self-reflector. And I think we all do this at times, but I think people who do it more often, you know, every year, every 6 months, every 3 to 6 months, these people recognize the changes that they need in life and changes that they need and want to happen. And they're willing to put the work in. And no matter what they go through, they have their good and bad days, just like the rest of us and in between times. But they know how to recognize what needs improvement and what needs to change. So surround yourself with people who are supportive, people who reflect about their life, and people who are here to make changes and be better. This is one of my favorite ones, to celebrate you. And I talked to a lot of my clients about this. Celebrate yourself. Remember that it's important to hug and kiss yourself, talk to yourself and tell yourself you're amazing. Remember to celebrate milestones. You know, you just graduated, or you passed a hard test, or a test you didn't even study for and didn't know you were going to have to take one for a job, or you just got a new promotion. You made some type of advancement. You just moved into a new place. It's better than your last place, or it's your first place and it's not the best, but it's yours. So just celebrate everything that you can to the best of your ability and hug yourself. Buy yourself something nice. Treat yourself to something luxurious here and there. Remember, say, you know what? I deserve this treat, or I deserve this. And it's okay to take yourself to a movie or just take yourself out. It's okay to splurge every now and then. You know, don't get crazy with it, but definitely celebrate yourself. It's important to remind yourself that, you know what, you are worth being celebrated, and you work hard, and everything that you've gone through and all your accomplishments is because you put in the time and the effort and the work and the diligence that it took. It's okay to celebrate and just have a good time with your family and friends and take some time for you and celebrate. The last one is look for lessons. Okay. Always know this, and you guys know I say this a lot, lessons are blessings, and it's about reflecting. And it's about making sure that after any type of situation, a breakup, parting from a friend, moving from a place, from any situation you go through, look at what you've learned. What is going to help you be better? Think about that, you know. What did I learn from that breakup? What did I learn from that person? Not just about how they treated me, but how did I treat myself? What did I tolerate? What did I allow that I should not have? What am I going to do differently next time so that that doesn't repeat? So that I can go to the next situation stronger, better, and wiser. And that is really important, that you reflect and that you look at those lessons. Because when you love yourself and you do better by yourself, you will respect yourself more. You will love yourself more. You will feel so much better about you and who you are. Okay, y'all. That is the life coaching session number 4. Love yourself. It's coming to a conclusion. I enjoy you. Love you. Hope you enjoyed this session. It always goes so fast to me. Please know I will still be doing tarot videos. You guys know I have Sundays coming up, the Sunday, Monday one. That is the weekly. And then I'll have the midweek by Wednesday-ish. And then I will have life coaching session number 5 in the next one. I hope you have enjoy life coaching session number 4. As I enjoy you, love you, wish all of you nothing but happiness, joy, and blessings. Peace always be unto you. Have a great weekend and be good to each other. Kiss your mom, kiss your dad, tell somebody you love them. Be good to the kids, eat some ice cream, spoil yourself a little bit, and have a beautiful weekend. It's sunny where I am. It's beautiful. The weather's gorgeous, and I just got some shopping done. So I'm hungry. I'm going to eat, and I hope all of you have something nice to eat on, and be loving. Love yourself. Bye, y'all.